Hey guys, what's up? John here from flyatmikealpha.com, coming at you for another 2-Minute Tuesday. Today we're going to be looking at this awesome footage right behind us of a high-density L2 takeoff with no flaps versus a low-density L2 takeoff with flaps and what a big difference that makes. Let's go intro. So we got two takeoffs here. Same airplane, same weight, same wind. Two key differences though. The one on the left, 20 degrees of flaps and 1,000 feet density altitude. The one on the right, no flaps, 6,500 feet density altitude. So which one do you think is going to take longer to take off? Obviously we already know, right? The one on the right is taking up substantially more runway, going a lot faster when it leaves the ground. But how much does this really matter to us, right? Well, let's look at some hard numbers. So the takeoff on the right took about 15 seconds longer than the takeoff on the left. Same airplane, same weight, same wind. Now, according to the Cessna manual, the POH, it's going to use about 400 more feet to take off from a 5,000 foot higher density altitude. Now, we can see that's kind of a load of BS because we were doing about 55 miles per hour when we rotated and got clear of the ground on the left. We were doing about 70 miles per hour when we got clear of the ground on the right. 15 seconds longer, 70 miles per hour, 100 feet per second, nearly 1,500 feet more. Now you can go ahead and extrapolate the math however you'd like. It might be a little different, maybe 1,200 feet more, 1,500 feet, whatever it is, it's a lot more runway than the book says. Don't count on those takeoff performance charts to actually save your life. You need to add a lot of cushion to them. Those are brand new airplanes under perfect circumstances with perfect pilots, and they are not the way the airplane's going to perform in the real world, as we can obviously see here. Now, obviously contributing to this is there's no flaps on the takeoff on the right, but according to the POH again, it says, well, 10 to 20 degrees of flaps is the same. So we use 20 degrees of flaps on the left, 10 degrees of flaps should be the same, and there can't be that big a difference between 10 and 0 degrees. So, while flaps would have helped substantially on the right, it still would not have got you off in just 400 more feet. You're going to use a lot more runway than that book really says at these high temperatures and high elevations. The one really interesting thing to note here is how the pilot even realized how fast the airplane was going over the ground and how it definitely should want to fly, and as they rotated, the airplane actually got into ground effect, and then without enough lift, it settled right back down, and that is all too common on high density altitude accidents where the aircraft leaves the ground momentarily, settles back down, and either stalls or impacts terrain at the end of the runway, a fence, trees, whatever it is, because the pilot was just desperately trying to get airborne when they clearly did not have enough lift, not enough air molecules for that wing to bite at to actually get that thing into the air. If you want to know how to calculate density altitude, we've got a great helpful short video on the YouTube channel for that, as well as a bunch of E6B calculation videos in the online ground school at flyatmikealpha.com. If you guys like this video, give it a thumbs up, go ahead and smash that like button, and subscribe to the YouTube channel if you have not already. Keep up with our latest episodes, including these awesome 2-Minute Tuesdays that come out, you guessed it, yeah, actually every Tuesday. If you want more awesome, concise videos to help you prepare for your private instrument or commercial check ride, or just for your regular private instrument or commercial ground school if you just need help getting through flight training, whether it's mastering crosswind landings, nailing down instrument approaches, or hitting those commercial maneuvers right on the head, go ahead and check out all the awesome courses online from Fly at Mike Alpha. And remember, guys, if you cannot fly every day, then fly8mikealpha.com. We'll see y'all next time.